Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Lauren. I am a homeschooling mom of three, and this channel is all about my homeschooling journey as well as some just regular motherhood stuff. This video is a FAQ video. I put out a post on Instagram where I asked people, you know, what were some of their questions that they had for me about homeschool. So I wanted to take a moment to answer those questions. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first question, and I have my little boop. So the first question is, what a day looks like and what curriculum do you use? Okay, so what does a homeschool day look like for us? Well, we start pretty slow. Our mornings are very slow, and I enjoy our slow mornings. I enjoy the fact that I am not having to rush out the door, you know, at 7 a.m. or that we're not, you know, doing that whole hustle and bustle thing. I really enjoy that. We really take our time in the morning, even though my kids are early risers. I mean, my son gets up at 6:45 a.m. We just kind of lounge around until it's time for school. We typically start school probably around nine-ish, maybe sometimes 10. That's typically when we'll start school. So the first thing that we start with is circle time, which is a great way to begin the day. It kind of gets us going in that kind of routine. If you've seen any of my day in the life videos, then you've already seen what circle time looks like for us. So after we do circle time, then we go ahead and get into our homeschool lesson of the day. When we break out, you know, whatever curriculum that we're gonna use for that day, activities, things like that. Our homeschool lesson is typically 30 to 45 minutes, which is an appropriate block of time given the age. You know, my kids are 3 and 5 years old, so we don't do our lessons for very long. We, you know, get our lesson done, 30, 45 minutes, and then the day is theirs, you know, after that. After we do our homeschool lesson, I do encourage them to maybe play an educational game on the laptop or on my phone. Games like ABC Mouse, Duolingo ABC, which is an amazing app. If you have not looked at Duolingo ABC, look it up. It's an amazing app for children and a really, really fun app. So they'll do any one of those apps. If they don't want to do those apps, you know, I don't force it on them. We already did our lesson. As I said, the day is theirs. They'll play outside. If it's a work day, they'll come with me to my mom's house, which is where I am now. And they'll play here, they'll watch TV, whatever they wanna do. We already did our lesson. Whatever they wanna do is what they do. The curriculum that we use really just depends on the day. If you've been on this channel, you're familiar with my channel, you know I've talked about Bookshark a million times. So we are still using Bookshark, but we are using it in a different capacity. Bookshark is a literature-based curriculum that we've been using since, I think like September, maybe October. No, September. So it's a literature-based curriculum, and just honestly, my kids just kind of got tired of the book load. I mean, it would be like a stack of books that we would get through every single day, and they just kind of got tired of that. So we just kind of pared it down, and now we are only using the Bookshark workbooks, which I love. The Bookshark workbooks are just so well put together. I love them. I credit the Bookshark workbooks for August being able to catch on with rhyming words. He's been struggling with rhyming words for such a long time, and it seems like it's finally starting to click, which is great to see. And I think that the Bookshark workbook is responsible for that. Just the activities and things like that make it easy to catch on to concepts such as rhyming. So we do the Bookshark workbook. We also do Hooked on Phonics. So we've been using the Hooked on Phonics workbook, which August loves a lot. So those are really the only two books that we use on a consistent basis. We may also add some other things as well as those, but as far as consistently, pretty much every single day, we do the workbooks from Bookshark and Hooked on Phonics. Next question is, how did you find curriculum or set up a unit study? So, this is an interesting question because I am a part of the Melanated Homeschool Review Squad, which gives me access to amazing resources and curriculum. So, the short answer is I have not really had to search for curriculum much. I did in the very beginning, but I have not recently. But in the very beginning of our homeschool journey, I did research curriculum, and it was incredibly overwhelming because there are so many different brands and companies, and it's hard to know, okay, which one should I choose? I mean, there's so much to choose from. There's, you know, all-in-one box curriculums. There's, you know, just you can do single subjects. There's digital curriculums, you know, physical copies. It's like, where do I go from here? So it can be really hard to choose a curriculum. If you're in that position and you're trying to figure out, okay, what do I choose for my homeschool? I would definitely suggest, if you are on Facebook, to join some homeschool Facebook groups. Look on the marketplace, check other secondhand platforms like, I can't think of them right now, but there are tons of them available so that you can have access to some secondhand curriculum so that you're not investing so much money into a curriculum that you're not sure if you're gonna like in the first place. So ask questions in groups, find some other homeschool parents, ask around. That's really the best thing that you can do. You can also check reviews online to help you make a choice. So that's, you know, that's really the best that you can do. You probably will buy a curriculum that you're not gonna like. That happened to me in the very beginning. I bought a curriculum that I thought I was gonna love. It was a nature-based curriculum. So I just thought it would be perfect for my oldest son, August. It was not. It was not perfect for August. Luckily, I didn't spend a whole lot of money on it. I think it was a digital curriculum that was maybe like $40, something like that. So it wasn't a whole lot of money, but it is sitting on my shelf collecting dust. It definitely is doing that right now. So yeah, definitely, you know, try to do as much research as you can before you make that purchase. I love unit studies. That is really all that we did before we started using the homeschool curriculums. We just did unit studies every single week that I created, and I love that process. It was a not an easy process, a little tedious, but it was so much fun because I got a chance to just be completely creative and to have activities that were just so much fun for the kids, and it was very enjoyable. I actually really miss doing unit studies, and yeah, you know, I want to incorporate more unit studies next year. But anyway, this is what I would do when I would come up with a unit study and, you know, try to figure out what we were going to do for that study. If I came up with a subject and it was like, oh, what about colors? I want to go over colors this week with my kids. I would head straight to Pinterest, look up color activities, type in the age range, and you'll see a whole bunch of pins, a whole bunch of ideas for activities, and I would literally just pin them to my board. That's where I would get all of my ideas from. I'm not very big on, you know, a whole lot of planning as far as like writing things down. It's just never really been my thing. I love to see it. I think it's, you know, really cool when people have everything all, you know, written down nice and neat, and they have their printables and all that. I love to see it. I would purchase from you guys, but I just don't do that myself. You know, our unit studies were very much activity based. So like with color activities, we did activities like with Jell-O, with food coloring and water, those kind of things. So that's what I built my unit studies around it. But I always started with Pinterest to get ideas and then worked from there to do my unit studies. There's actually two other creators on YouTube who just did unit study videos that y'all should check out if you're not familiar. I'll put their handles somewhere on this video. I'll link them below as well, because they are homeschool mamas that you should definitely follow if you are not following them already. And they actually just did unit study videos. One of them did a anatomy unit study video. The other one just did a taco unit study video. Both so interesting. Definitely check it out. So yeah, so that's how I would do unit studies. Okay, this one says how to do different ages at the same time. That is a great question, because I did not think that I would have to do anything different, really, for August and Axel. They are 2 years apart. And in my mind, I don't know why, but in my mind, I really thought that they could really do the same things, pretty much. So I would just have one lesson, and we would just do that one lesson. And I realized that more times than not, Axel, my youngest, would be bored, you know, kind of disruptive. She might get up and just leave altogether. And I was just like, oh, well, you know, maybe she's just not interested in school right now, you know, which is fine. She's three, so that's fine. But it wasn't until actually a couple months ago where it was like, she's not interested because she knows that this is not for her. And it wasn't. The lessons were really for August. The age range and all of that, you know, is five and up. So she was bored. She was uninterested because she knew that it wasn't for her. So I had to make it for her. So the last couple months, I had completely separate lessons for Axel, and it has changed the game, completely changed the game. And nothing, you know, complicated, just very simple. I wasn't, you know, printing a whole bunch of stuff and doing a whole lot of research. I mean, she's three, so the concepts are, you know, pretty simple. Right now we're really focusing on letter recognition, recognizing the letters themselves, recognizing the sounds, our shapes, our numbers, things like that, you know? So the last couple months, I've just been making the worksheets myself. Literally started on construction paper, and I would just write on there, like, you know, and I'll put pictures somewhere, like circle the letter N's, you know, on the construction paper. I would write a bunch of letters on there, including the letter N, and would just tell her, I want you to find the lowercase letter N, and I want you to circle it. And that's what she would do. Super simple, but very engaging. And she loved the fact that it was just for her, that it, she felt like she had her place in our homeschool, which was important to her, which completely went over my head, you know, until a couple months ago. So I'm glad that I did come to that realization, because like I said, it's completely changed the game with her. She is interested in homeschool. She doesn't ditch. It's funny, before my husband, you know, would ask her, like, Axel, you going to school today? Because she would be like, no, you know. But she does not ditch school anymore. She feels like she's a part of things. So that has just been great to see. Like I said, I did start out with construction paper, but now I just write whatever it is on. I have a little whiteboard. I have like a set of three of these little whiteboards. So in an effort to be more eco-friendly, I've just been doing the whatever worksheet it is on the whiteboard, and she can just erase. So whether it's, you know, circle this letter, circle this number, I'll draw a shape or whatever it is, or have her draw it. I'll do dashed lines and have her trace it with a marker. Very simple. You know, the simpler, the better, as far as I'm concerned with our homeschool. So I just keep it simple, keep it fun, and they're both engaged. While Axel is doing her thing, August will do something independently. So he'll do the Hooked on Phonics workbooks. He's able to do that independently. I might set him up on a computer game, you know, learning how to type with Type-C. I will set him up with ABC Mouse, Duolingo, Night Zookeeper. Any one of those computer games, I will set him up on that. And he can, you know, pretty much do it on his own, while Axel and I are doing our own thing. How do I incorporate time to myself? Well, I don't. Next question. No, I'm kidding. but seriously, I don't. And I know that's a problem, but it's just, it's hard. And something that I'm working on, but I don't incorporate time to myself. I want to, and I will, hopefully, soon, but I don't. When I got this question, I kind of paused. I kind of froze because, you know, it really made me realize, like, oh, wow, like, I don't have an answer for this question at all, because I don't know how. You know, if other homeschool parents are going through the same thing of trying to figure out, you know, how do I get some time to myself? I'm so overwhelmed and, you know, exhausted, all of those things. It's like, you know, I'm right there with you and I'm trying to figure it out myself. We'll get there. All right, so the last question, a lot of people wanted to find out, how do I keep it fun? How do I keep homeschool fun? Because, you know, school has a reputation for just not being fun. And school itself, you know, the learning aspect of school growing up for me was not fun. I was a student who performed well in school, but that was never fun. That was never fun for me. So it's, I love the fact that I am now able to make education fun for my kids. So how do we keep it fun? We keep it fun by keeping it exciting. We don't do the same thing every day. We do, you know, do the Bookshark workbook and the Hooked on Phonics workbook, but that takes all of maybe 5 to 10 minutes. And after that, we kind of switch it up. So we may do a sensory activity. We may do a day where I just tell the kids, you know, today is our computer lab day. So we're just doing, you know, computer programs. As I've mentioned several times already in this video, you know, ABC Mouse, Duolingo, Night Zookeeper, Type C, PBS Kids, all of those fun apps, you know, or programs. We may just do that for our homeschool lesson, which the kids love. We may go somewhere. We're members at our zoo and museum. So it might be a zoo day, it might be a museum day, and we'll use those days to learn. We don't simply just, you know, walk around and smile at everything. We're stopping and talking about the different animals if we're at the zoo, their natural habitats. We're talking about what do they look like. You know, for Axel, we're looking at, you know, is this animal furry? Is this animal scaly? You know, things like that, noticing differences. When we're at the museum, we're looking at dinosaurs. We're talking about, you know, what kind of dinosaur is this? Do you think this dinosaur was a carnivore or an herbivore, or why? You know, so I'm that parent. We're not just, you know, walking around smiling at everything. We're learning while we're having fun as well. There might be a day where we go in the kitchen and, you know, today we're cooking breakfast. I'll break out all the ingredients and we'll talk about each ingredient individually and what it does. Why is that ingredient important to the process that we're doing right now? You know, that sort of thing. So I think all of that really helps to keep it fun and keep it interesting while we're still learning. So yeah, I think that that's a way that, you know, we can make education fun. I love getting out of the house. That's definitely one of my favorite things to do. So yeah, we'll take some field trips for sure, in an effort to keep things fun. So I hope that I've answered your questions. If you have any other questions, feel free to leave them below. I would love to answer them. And if you already have your, you know, your routine of what you do to get time for yourself, you know, reading a book, whatever it is, comment below as well, because I would love to get ideas as I discover, you know, what it is that I like to do to take time for myself. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a like. If you're not already, please subscribe to my channel for more content, and I will see y'all later.